There have been a lot of science books written about meditation. And what I wanted to do with Bliss Brain was something different. I wanted a book that would be so convincing that it would get people to meditate. Now, over 100,000 people read my earlier book, Mind to Matter. And we've now had hundreds and hundreds of people emailing into us, telling us that that was the book that convinced them to meditate. So 100,000 people or so have gotten that message from my earlier book, Mind to Matter. What my goal is with Bliss Brain is to see millions of people being convinced to meditate through reading this book. I want to make a compelling case for why it'll change your life. And there are studies in the book showing that it not just makes you feel better during meditative practice you have each day, it makes you far more productive in your everyday life. So if you aren't meditating for the feel-good part of it, meditate because you get much more productive. Your problem-solving ability and your creativity increases dramatically after you experience those elevated states. With the release of Bliss Brain in September 2020, I also really wanted to address all of the upheavals of that year, like the coronavirus pandemic early in the year, the financial and economic crash that followed, the huge unemployment, the dislocation to so many people's lives, the fear, all of the confusion that followed that. And I really not only wanted to make the book relevant to people individually, I wanted to make the book relevant to the global crises we find ourselves in. So Bliss Brain isn't just a book about you and you feeling better. It's also a book about the world we live in, how these kinds of experiences make you far more resilient in the face of global challenges, and how that no matter how the world goes from this point on, no matter how the world evolves in subsequent years, you will be that resilient person equal to the challenges that you face.